Hello students, today we are going to study the new lesson, that is oscillation. Oscillation is the most interesting concept in our physics. At first we have to know about the oscillation. Oscillation means it is the motion of an object which takes place to and fro or forward or backward direction or up and down. In that motion it is called as oscillation. The motion which takes place to and fro or forward or backward direction, in that motion of an object it is called as oscillation. In daily life we come across the many examples of an oscillation. First example is the motion of pendulum in a clock. Suppose that this is the pendulum. In a clock, then when this pendulum moves towards, this is the mean position and this is the extreme position. When this pendulum moves towards extreme position, then it moves in a forward or backward direction, then it moves to the extreme position, then it complete displacement, it is at extreme position, is the maximum displacement of that pendulum. The motion of the pendulum takes place forward and backward direction. Then that motion of an object, it is called as oscillation. When pendulum moves forward or backward direction, that motion is also called as oscillation. This is the example of pendulum in a clock. Also we see the another example of an oscillation, it is the motion of needle in a swaying machine, as well as the motion of spring, motion of the prongs of tuning fork, also vibrations of sitar, guitar. These are the examples of an oscillation. In that cases, the motion of an object repeat after equal interval of time. This motion repeat after equal interval of time, therefore that motion it is called as periodic motion. And oscillatory motion obeys this periodic motion, means motion repeat after equal interval of time. And this motion repeatedly performs this set of movement, and time taken by this set of movement it is called as time period. Oscillatory motion, it is periodic motion in which velocity, acceleration and displacement, these are represented by the harmonic function. Therefore oscillatory motion obeys this harmonic function, then that motion it is called as simple harmonic motion. Therefore, that motion it is called as simple harmonic motion. And when this motion it takes place along this straight line path, this motion of an object takes place along this straight line path, then that motion of an object it is called as linear simple harmonic motion. And when this motion of an object takes place along the arc of circle, then that motion it is called as angular simple harmonic motion. But at first we have to study here the linear simple harmonic motion. At first we have to study here linear simple harmonic motion. Therefore we have to draw here figure of spring mass oscillator. Spring mass oscillator. In this diagram we have to draw the three diagrams, figure first, figure second and figure third. In figure A we see here the stretched position of spring, in figure B there is relaxed position of the spring, and figure C represent compressed position of spring. Place for that purpose place horizontal. Place this block, the block of mass M, on the frictionless horizontal surface having mass M. Consider one end of spring to the rigid support and consider other end of spring to the block of mass M. Then figure B represent the relaxed position or mean position of the spring and block. In that position, both spring and block are rest position, therefore force acting on the block, it is equal to 0. Force acting on the block, it is equal to 0. Therefore, it is called as relaxed position of the spring, or this is the mean position of the spring or equilibrium position of the spring. When this block of mass M, in this block of mass M is moved to the right side, moves to the right side, then this is the right side and this is the left side. When this block of mass M moves towards the right side, then force exerted by the spring on the block is towards the right, towards the left side. Because on the basis of elastic properties, the spring exerts the restoring force on the block. When this block displaces towards the right side, then spring exerts the restoring force on the block towards the left side. Because on the basis of elastic properties, the spring, it will try to bring this block to its mean position. It will try to bring this mean position. Therefore, force, restoring force acting on the block is towards the left side. And second is also relaxed position, therefore there is no force acting on the block. In third position, we see here compressed, and spring is compressed towards the left side through the distance x. Then this is the left side and this is the right side. Then this block displaces towards the left side on the either side of equilibrium position, and when it releases, then it performs oscillation to and fro. Then the spring, it will try to go its equilibrium position on the basis of elastic properties. Therefore, force acting on the block by the spring is towards the right side. Therefore, in three cases we see here, when displacement of a block takes place towards the right side, and then at that time restoring force exerted by the spring on the block towards the left side. When displacement is right side, then force acting on the block is towards the left side. In first case, when spring is stretched and when it is at rest position, then force acting on the block, it is equal to 0. And when this block is moves towards the left side or right side, we see here the force acting on the block is opposite side. From this we can write here restoring force acting on the block, it is given by restoring force acting on the block by the spring, it is denoted by M, and this force, it is directly proportional to the displacement. Therefore, restoring force acting on the block, it is given by F is equal to minus K, where F is restoring force, K is force constant, and X is the displacement. Therefore, restoring force is equal to F is equal to minus K, K is force constant, and X is displacement. therefore resulting force is equal to minus K. From this three diagram we see the definition of the linear superharmonic motion. When this block is moved to the right side and release it, then it performs to and fro oscillation. Therefore, this block accelerated towards the another side and force displaces towards the another side. Therefore, force and displacement both are oppositely directed. Therefore, acceleration of the block, it is given by acceleration, it is denoted by A, and it is given by F by M. Therefore, acceleration, the value of F is minus Kx. Therefore, we can write here F into K by M into X. Say this equation 1 and 2. This is the acceleration of an block. From this, we can define the linear simple harmonic motion. It is the linear periodic motion of the particle in which force or acceleration, it is directed towards the mean position and it is directly proportional to the displacement. And both direction of displacement and force are oppositely directed. Therefore, linear periodic motion, it is the periodic motion of the particle in which force or acceleration, it is always directed towards the mean position and it is directly proportional to the displacement. This is the linear simple harmonic motion we see here. Then after that, we can study here the differential equation of the linear simple harmonic motion. Differential equation of linear simple harmonic motion. Now we study here the restoring force acting on the block. It is directly proportional to the displacement, and the direction of force and displacement both are oppositely directed. Therefore, the restoring force in linear system, it is given by restoring force F. It is given by F is equal to minus Kx. Therefore, we can say this equation number 1. In linear SHM, the restoring force acting on the body, it is given by F is equal to minus K. F is the force, K is the force constant, and X is the displacement. Then, according to Newton's second law of motion, we know that F is equal to mass into acceleration. Say this equation number 2. Where F is the force, M is the mass, and A is the acceleration of particle. But acceleration, it is the equal to the rate of change of velocity with respect to time. Also, v is the velocity of particle and it is the ratio of distance with respect to time. That is, we can write here dx by v. Put value of v in A. Therefore, equation becomes A is equal to dv of dx by dt. Therefore, equation can be written as d square x divided by dt square. Therefore, this equation is 3. put this equation 3 into V gain. We get F is equal to M into d square x divided by dt square. Say this equation number 4. Then from equation 1 and 4 we can see here restoring force is equal to minus ks and force is equal to M d square x divided by dt square. Compare equation. Comparing equation 1 and 4 we get. Comparing equation 1 and 4 we get. Therefore M d square x dt square it is equal to minus kx. Take this minus term to that side, therefore equation become m into d square x divided by dt square plus kx. It is equal to 0. Remove this m, therefore equation become d square x divided by dt square plus k by m into x, it is equal to 0. Return occur, put k by m, it is equal to omega square, where omega is the angular frequency of the body. Therefore, equation become d square x dt square plus omega square x. Say this equation number 5. Therefore, this is the d square x divided by dt square plus omega square x represent the differential equation of linear motion. You can see here d square x divided by dt square plus omega square x, it is equal to 0, which represent the differential equation of linear simple harmonic motion. In this lecture we are studying about the introduction of an oscillation as well as the linear simple harmonic motion, and also third article is our differential equation of linear simple harmonic motion. Thank you.